to go ahead.
It's an interesting story, whereas you feel as though it wasn't fair for you to be told what to do, because you didn't know of the options. And then it seems as though that you're very aggressive about trying to get women to not abort their babies.
So this is what's fair. I'm going to answer the question for you, but I'm going to answer it according to the truth and not what you feel, and I want you to be quiet and let me answer the question, okay? The reality is this, that when that woman decided to sleep with that man, that was her choice, and she got pregnant. I'm not saying that she had to, I'm not done, I'm working to be quiet and I want to answer the question. The reality is this, that woman could have given that baby up for adoption. She didn't have to keep that baby, but she does need to hold that baby for 9 months. Why? Because that was her choice to sleep with that baby. And even in rape, it is selfish to murder a baby based off whatever someone else did. That baby still deserves to live. My mother chose life. My mom chose life, and that's why I'm standing here today. So when you choose death, you're being selfish. When you are pro-choice, you are pro-self. And you can care less about anybody else. It's about you, and that's it. And that is against the will of God and his people.
Oh my God,
and if they want to stand here and ask us to be selfless, they need to do the same thing and be selfless as well. Because an innocent baby's life is at stake. Concludes the interview.